Global warming is a real threat. Climate change is a real threat. And everybody of us is contributing to it because we have a carbon footprint. And we can do something about it by reducing our carbon footprint by consuming less. For example, driving around less in our cars, eating less meat, things like that. But something that many people don't have on their minds is that they also have a carbon footprint when they are investing. Because you might be invested either consciously, if you have shares, or unconsciously through your pensions, you're invested into industries that produce these goods, car manufacturers, meat manufacturers. And our question is, what should you do optimally? It's a kind of optimization. You want to optimize your impact. You want to minimize your carbon footprint as far as you can, but also the costs should not be too large that you have to bear. And that's our optimization question. What should you optimally do if you want to reduce your individual carbon footprint? We construct a theoretical model, which means it's a mathematical world that we build up. And in this model, we have two kinds of players. The ones that care, we call responsible households, and the ones that don't care. Then we can make our mathematical calculations. We can calculate how much if they reduce their investment or if they reduce their consumption, how much the aggregate carbon footprint is affected. If you buy fewer cars, and that means maybe somebody else is just going to buy these cars. So you have a sacrifice that's not effective. The same thing is possible also on the investment side. If you don't buy the shares of a polluting company, maybe somebody else will buy these shares of the polluting company, and then the aggregate effect is zero. So the question is your sacrifice effective? And the second question is, given that it is effective, how should I mix between the two different channels? So what are the key findings? Our first finding is very robust, and that means it is not affected by the specific assumptions that we make in the model, and that is that both channels, reduction of investment and reduction and in consumption, they're both effective. But the size of the effect is different. So, second question is, what's the optimal mix? And what we find in the model is that if one of these channels is especially effective, that typically means it's also costly. If, for example, not eating meat by you means that others will not jump in, that also means that a reduction in meat consumption for you is more costly in equilibrium. That has the consequence that the efficient mix of the two channels always involves both. So you should always reduce investment and reduce consumption. So there is no hierarchy. Typically, in the public opinion, you think that there is some kind of hierarchy. First, you should look at your consumption choices, and then if you're very sophisticated, maybe then in the second step also think about your optimal investment, green investing, something like that. But in our model, that's not the case. There is no hierarchy. Both should be looked at simultaneously. I should first say that we have written this paper to answer a question that comes from our hearts, or the two authors of the paper. How much responsibility should we put on our investment decisions, and how much responsibility we should put on our consumption decisions? So I think this is a really important question, especially now in these times of climate change. One effect that we hope that our paper has is that the media coverage, the public opinion already puts a lot of stress on the carbon footprint that our consumption choices have. And we just want to stress the other side, the investment side, which our paper shows is just as important. We want to put the limelight also on the investment side. Even if it's a little bit more abstract, Many people maybe think, well, I'm not invested at all. It doesn't affect me. I don't own any shares. Well, maybe you do indirectly through a pension fund because you have a bank account. And so indirectly through the bank, you're invested into brown companies. It could go through insurance companies. If you choose your portfolio suboptimally, if you have too many brown investments, that means that your aggregate choice is ineffective. You could have a larger effect, and that's what you want to have an effect, and you could have a larger effect by readjusting between the two channels of responsibility. We have only looked at two channels of responsible behavior, and that's the investment channel and the consumption channel, but there are more channels that one might think of. For example, channel of political engagement, going to demonstrations, to climate strikes, things like that. That would be something that one can do. That's also a sacrifice because every Friday you have to sacrifice for the demonstrations. And another channel that might be interesting is the labor market, because you might have the choice to between working for a polluting firm and a non-polluting firm. If you work in a non-polluting firm, your salary might be different, so you might have less money to invest, so you might have less leeway in your investment choices, things like that. And of course, at some point, it would also be nice to take it to the data, because our model also has predictions about what should be the expected returns of investments in the different sectors, polluting and non-polluting sectors. It would also be nice to compare that with the empirical findings that are already there. So different roads that one could follow.